Well, should we get into, so we have King James Version onlyists. We have quite a bit of that in our subreddit. And yeah. This isn't a question we prepared here. So this is, we're going off script here for a second. But does that fall back under the question we had about, you know, keeping the main thing and, you know, focusing on what's important, majoring in the minors? Or what should we say for those of us who have no problem reading ESV, NLT, NIV even? For those of us who are fine with that, how do we interact with those who say, no, it's King James Version only? And it's not just because, you know, it was good enough for Jesus, but it's, you know, the arguments that are made are very they're very logical arguments about, you know, the manuscripts that were used for the translation of the King James Version. They were the authentic ones, and yes, there's been older stuff discovered since then, but those are corrupt in some ways. I mean, what's a way for us, those of us who aren't bound to the King James Version, to deal with somebody who's hung up on it? So that sounds kind of offensive, but
yeah,
they're a proponent of King James Version only, and everything else is just bad.
I guess the first question I have is, like, are they making it a major, or is it just something they believe where they go, you know, that you could tell they feel a little uncomfortable, but they're still going to fellowship with you. They're not going to, like, interrupt your Bible study. They're not going to walk out of your church. They're not going to fire you if you're on staff. And you're like, you know, I walked into my fellowship one time carrying an ESV Bible, and somebody came up to me and he was like, what is that? That's ESV. This should be King James, Mike, or New King James at least, you know? And then he went and complained, and, you know, people know that he's that way, whatever. It was really awkward, to be honest. And like a week later, the things he said to me, and a week later he came up to me and he was like, you know what? I'm sorry. I overreacted. You're my brother. I love you and appreciate what you're doing. And then you could tell he just thought, we just won't talk about that issue. I could totally accept that. I don't have to change his mind. So can they fellowship with me in spite of this issue? And if the answer is no, they can't fellowship, then that's when I want to talk about it, maybe a little bit with them. I don't feel like I have to change your mind on this. If you're interested, I have teaching on it, right? I have teaching on Bible translations, and I've got a whole thing on evidence for the Bible. That series goes in great detail. It's why I'm not King James only. But and if people are looking for a book, I'd recommend James White's book on this. It's fantastic, super accessible, really well done, and it's called King James Only Controversy. Okay. Really well done. Yeah, I'd recommend that book. That'll give you the talking points and things to discuss with people, or my video series on translations, which I guess I can link below whenever I upload this. And the question is, can they still fellowship with me in spite of this? If they can, then I don't have to change their mind. I can feel out that relationship. Is this something we can discuss or no? Either way, it's okay. If I can't fellowship with them because of this, then let's maybe address it and see if we can overcome it together.
Yeah. Okay.